Light. Light is a kind of energy traveling at a very high speed. It is required to see things around us. Life would be very difficult to imagine without light. It travels through space at a speed of about 3 lakh kilometers per second, 480s or 8 minutes. If you could travel at a speed of light, you could go more than 7 times around the world in 1 second. However, light too travels through different mediums through different speeds. It travels the fastest through vacuum. It is slower in air and much slower in water. Scientists believe that nothing can travel faster than light. This is because there is not enough energy in the whole universe to make even the smallest thing reach that speed. When the light falls on an object, 3 things can happen. The light or a part of it can reflect off the object, pass through it, or be absorbed by it. A metal plate appears shiny because it reflects a large part of the light falling on it. Rocks, on the other hand, look dull because these absorb a large part of the light falling on them. Rectilinear propagation of light. Light does not require any medium to travel, otherwise it would not have been ever reached us through the space, which is a vast vacuum. All sources of light like torch, candle, bulb emit light in all the directions in straight lines. Light from projector travels in straight light in the form of rays towards the screen. It cannot bend or flow around the corners. This mode of traveling in straight lines is called rectilinear propagation. Thus, one can say that light travels in straight lines. Reflection of light. When you look in a mirror, you see your image. This image is formed due to the reflection of light by the object. The process of bouncing back of light from the surface of an object is called reflection. Due to the reflection of light, the image is formed. The reflection occurs in 2 ways: regular reflection and irregular reflection. Regular reflection and irregular reflection. When a well-polished and smooth surface gets a parallel beam of light falling on it, the reflected rays are also parallel. This reflection is called regular reflection. When a parallel beam of light falls on a rough surface, the reflected rays travel in different directions. That is, they are not parallel. Such a reflection is called irregular reflection. What is an image? Look in a mirror, you will see the reflection of yourself. This reflection is called an image. An image is an actual representation of an object. It is formed by a smooth surface, such as still water and mirrors. The eyes of animals, including humans, have lens to produce image. The devices like camera, telescopes, and microscopes have lenses to form image. The reflection of light by different surfaces have different properties. The image formed by the different mirrors have different characteristics. The mirrors are basically of 2 types. They are plane mirrors and spherical mirrors, concave mirrors and convex mirrors. A plane mirror. A plane mirror is any mirror with a flat reflective surface. It reflects the light at the same angle it hits the mirror. So there is very little distortion of the image, if any. The mirror hanging in our bathroom is a plane mirror. So the mirrors are polished surfaces coated with mercury such that they reflect most of the light falling on them. Characteristics of image formed by plane mirror. The image formed on plane mirror shows some characteristics. The image is virtual and erect. The image formed by a plane mirror is always virtual. A virtual image is a copy of an object formed at the location from which the light rays appear to come. It is upright and of the same shape and size as the object it is reflecting. You cannot touch this image, but still the image exists. The image is laterally inverted. If a person is reflected in a plane mirror, the image of his right hand appears to be the left hand of the image. In general, the right side of an object becomes the left side of the image formed by a plane mirror and vice versa. This interchange of sides between an object and its image is called lateral inversion. The word ambulance on an ambulance is written in the way of mirror writing, so that when the driver of a vehicle ahead of an ambulance looks in her or his rear view mirror, he or she can read ambulance written on it and give way to it. It is the duty of every one of us to allow an ambulance to pass without blocking its way. The image is of same size as the object. Try to see the flame of the candle in the mirror. It appears as if a familiar candle is placed behind the mirror. The candle which appears behind the mirror is the image of the candle formed by the mirror. The candle itself is the object. Now, move the candle to different positions in front of the mirror. Observe the image in each case. You can see the image of the candle upright and the flame appears on top of the candle just like as in the object. Such an image is called erect. An image formed by a plane mirror is erect and of the same size as the object. The image is formed at the same distance as object is placed from the mirror. Take a small sized mat and keep it an eraser on it. Fix a small sized plane mirror on the edge of the mat. Note the image of the eraser. Now shift the eraser on the other side of the mat. Again note the position of the image. You will find that the image is at the same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. Spherical mirrors. When the mirror is a part of a sphere, it is called a spherical mirror. It is a mirror which has the shape of a piece cut out of a spherical surface shown in figure. Spherical mirrors are of two types, concave mirror and convex mirror. In a concave mirror, the reflective surface inside the sphere, that is depressed. In convex mirror, the reflective surface is outside the sphere, that is bulged or protruded. The most commonly occurring examples of concave mirrors are shaving mirrors and makeup mirrors. These mirrors magnify objects placed close to them. The convex mirrors are side wing mirrors of cars. The object which appears in them looks smaller than their actual size. Important terms related to spherical mirrors. The pole, P of the spherical mirror is the center of the spherical mirror. The center of curvature, C of a spherical mirror is the center of the sphere of which the mirror forms a part. The radius of curvature of a spherical mirror is the radius of the sphere of which the mirror forms a part. The principal axis of a spherical mirror is the line joining the pole and the center of curvature of the mirror. The curved shining surface of a spoon acts as a mirror. The most common example of a curved mirror is a spherical mirror. It is the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror is concave. It is called a concave mirror. If the reflecting surface is convex, then it is a convex mirror. Image formed by concave mirrors. A concave mirror, which is also called as converging mirror, has its reflecting surface bulging inwards, that is, away from the incident light. In case of convex mirror, the image is usually inverted, real and smaller than the object. When the object is kept too close to the concave mirror, the image is erect, virtual, and larger than the object. Uses of concave mirror. There are numerous uses of concave mirror in daily life. In the aircraft landing, concave mirror is used to guide the airplanes. It is used as a torch to reflect the light rays. Concave mirrors are used during shaving to get an erect and enlarged image of the face. Dentists and ENT specialists use it to focus a beam of light to see inside a patient's mouth or ears. It is used as barber's mirror because it shows a larger image when object is too close. Concave mirrors are widely used in headlights of automobiles and motor vehicles, torch lights, railway engines, etc. as reflectors. Large concave mirrors are used to focus sunlight to produce heat in the solar furnace. They are also used in solar ovens to collect a large amount of solar energy in the focus of the concave mirror for heating, cooking, melting metals, etc. Image formation and convex mirror. Convex mirror is a curved mirror where the reflective surface bulges out towards the light source. This bulging out surface reflects light outwards and are not used to focus light. These mirrors form a virtual image as the focal point F and the center of curvature 2F are imaginary points in the mirror that cannot be reached. This results in the formation of images that cannot be projected on a screen as the image is inside the mirror. The image looks smaller than the object from the distance but gets larger as the object gets closer to the mirror. In case of convex mirror, the image is erect, virtual, and smaller than the object. Uses of convex mirror. Convex mirrors are often used in the hallways of buildings, including stores, schools, hospitals, hotels, and apartment buildings. They are used in driveways and roads to provide safety to the drivers at curves and other places where there is lack of visibility. They are also used in some automated teller machines as a handy security feature that allow users to see what all is happening behind them. Convex mirrors are used in rear-view mirrors as it shows a smaller image from a bigger field of view. These are used on hairpin bends to see the vehicles coming from the other side of the bend. Lenses. A lens is a transparent piece of glass or plastic with curved surfaces. It is a type of mirror which refracts the light instead of reflection. Refraction is the bending of a light when it enters a medium. Here, the medium is lens. Lenses are of various types, but the two most important types are convex lens or converging lens and concave lens or diverging lens. Important terms used in lenses. The center of the lens is called the optical center, O. A ray of light that passes through the optical center emerges on the other side without any changes. The principal axis is the line passing through the optical center and perpendicular to the surface of the lens. The principal focus F of a convex lens is a point on the principal focus of a concave lens is a point on the principal axis, which rays parallel to the principal axis appear to diverge. The focal length F of a lens is the distance between the optical center and the principal focus. Image formation in convex lens. The convex lens is thicker at the center than at the edges, and its both the surfaces are convex. Since the image can be captured on the screen, it is a real image. It is formed by actual rays of light that pass through the lens. In case of convex lens, the image is usually inverted, real, and smaller than the object. When the object is kept too close to the convex lens, the image is erect, virtual, and larger than the object. One common example of convex lens is magnifying lens. When sunlight is focused by a converging magnifying glass, it can burn the paper. Light rays from the sun are nearly parallel and cross the focal point of the lens. The more powerful the lens, the closer to the lens the rays will cross. Uses of convex lens. The convex lenses are many uses in our everyday life. The magnifying glass represents one of the simplest, most direct applications of a converging lens. As a light enters the lens, it becomes focused to a specific focal point in front of the center of the lens. Once you bring the magnifying glass to the optimal distance, so the focal point reaches the object and the object will appear at maximum magnification. Move the glass further from the object and it will become distorted. Move the glass closer to the object and it will decrease in magnification. In case of farsightedness, the lens of the eye focuses the image too far behind the retina. This causes difficulty in focusing on objects close to the eye. A converging lens placed on the eye bends the incoming light sharply so that the focal point shortens and the light focuses properly on the retina. Cameras utilize converging lenses not only to focus an image but also to magnify it. Microscopes utilize converging lenses to create extremely magnified images of small objects. Image formation concave lens. A concave lens is thicker at the center than at the edges. In case of a concave lens, the image is erect, virtual, and smaller than the object. A concave lens does not form a real image. Its both the surfaces are concave. It diverges light. That is the reason it is also called a diverging lens. Uses of concave lens. Concave lenses have important uses. Opticians use concave lenses to correct nearsightedness or myopia. A nearsighted eyeball is too long and the image of a far away object falls short of the retina. Concave lenses in glasses correct the shortfall by spreading out the light before it reaches the eye, thereby enabling the person using them to see distant objects more clearly during photography. Camera manufacturers use combinations of concave and convex lenses to improve the quality of photographs. Combining convex lens and concave lenses eliminates both undesirable effects during photography. Concave lenses are used on flashlights to magnify the light produced by the bulb. The light falls on the concave side of the lens and the rays diverge on the other side, thereby increasing the apparent radius of the light source and providing a wider beam. Various types of medical equipments, scanners and CD players use laser beams. Small concave lenses can widen a laser beam to precisely access a specific area. Door viewers or peepholes are small security devices that provide a panoramic view of objects outside the doors or walls. Components of white light. You can see light in various colors. For example, the red, green, orange lights of traffic signals, the yellow light of candle flame, the blue light of gas stove, and so on. But the sunlight does not seem to have any particular color. This kind of light is called white light. However, when sunlight falls on soap bubbles or on oil floating on a puddle of water on the road, you can see many colors. These colors may be of white light that falls in them. When a narrow beam of light falls at an angle on a prism, the white light gets split into lights of different colors, which appears as a continuous band of colors on the prism wall. This collection or set of lights of different colors is called the spectrum of white light. The spectrum as a band of colors can be seen in a rainbow, produced by separation of the components of light by their different degrees of refraction according to wavelength. The white light or visible spectrum is composed of 7 colors. These colors are vibrio, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. When white light passes through a prism, it breaks down into its component colors. This is the reason rainbows show all the colors of the visible spectrum. This is due to dispersion of light. The phenomenon of splitting of white light into its component colors is called dispersion of light. Newton's disc. Newton's disc is a circular disc with segments painted in rainbow colors, that is violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red, in that order. When the disc is rotated, the colors fade to white. Sir Isaac Newton used this disc to demonstrate that white light is a combination of the 7 different colors found in a rainbow. Since Newton was the first to make this,